1967, and I woke up with bandages on my stomach. And these scars will stay with me the rest of my life. They said she was feeble-minded and promiscuous, even mentally retarded. But I didn't want it, and I didn't approve it. And I said, can't I just go home and see if I get along a little better? Can I just go home and see if I get along a little better? Who says what women do? Women like us don't cry when we laugh. We do when we laugh. We do.
Collapse came, but we worked together. We banded together. We used our resources. He's after me. In profits, there's no peace.
In profits, there's no peace.
But in equity, we shine.
But in equity, we shine.
I lived through a time where I had no choice but to learn what it was like to live on the margins of a world built by and for whites. The post-Trump era, a time where folk brazenly exhibited their arrogance and all-American ignorance. We created a kingdom, we created a stronghold. Created an unconquerable land.
Here I am! Here I am, fat, black, and underestimated! Here I am! Here I am! With no reflection. Someone that sees me. Here I am, trying to forget. Every single special way I learned to hate myself.
I am allowed to be completely myself, no permission.
I'm grateful.
I am healing every day.
I love myself enough to be who I am.
Today will be a celebration
of being alive. Hunger will be a stranger. Lack will be a myth. Self-hate will be a distant memory. Sister, I see you. I remember you. You are not a ghost. We are alive. I see you. With your heartbreak and your triumph, with your desperation and your hopefulness, with your rage and your resilience, with your scars and your flawlessness, I see all of us. With our access cards and our PhDs, apple-bottom jeans and mud cloth, with our 27 pieces and our head shaved clean, sister, only you have the brilliance, tenacity, ingenuity, and audacity to survive in America.